Hello everyone, Michael here with the Daily Note 203 YouTube channel, and this is a viewer requested video, and the question was, how well is Evernote integrated into the Galaxy Note 3? Because it really wasn't well integrated in the Galaxy Note 2. And the short answer is yes, they've taken many steps to make that integration much better. So for example, when you had a S note, let's create a quick one here. There was even a sync to Evernote option. The problem was when you went to Evernote, let's do a sync here, and you try to open this file, it just did not know how to open this file. Now on the Galaxy Note 3, let's take that same file that we just created on the Galaxy Note 2, and it will know how to open this file. It's going to open up SNote and it'll recognize that it's an older SNote file from the Galaxy Note 2, and it's going to import it and then make it a new format. Unfortunately, I just received the Evernote update and that functionality is now broken, but hopefully they'll fix that in the future. I just want to demonstrate how it should work, so I'm going to uninstall the update. So let's go to Edit. App info, uninstall updates. It says it will be replaced by the factory version. Let's go back to Evernote here. Let's sign in. And now when we sync here and I open this, it says the file will be modified so that it is supported by the newer version of SNote. And there you go. You can see that SNote has opened and it has even imported the background as well. I think it just imported a flat image and made it the background, so you could see the eraser function doesn't work at all. But hey, at least we get to see the note. Now you don't have to go through Evernote at all to import older SNote files onto the Galaxy Note 3. You just need to send them to yourself by email, or even better, just copy the files directly. And when you try to open those files, I just sent one to myself by email. It just knows how to do this. So I just showed you how to import your older SNote files into your Galaxy Note 3, but I just want to show you the regular functionality. Say you create a SNote and you open up Evernote. So you could see it shows up there. What's interesting is that the new Evernote update, it had some air view functionality. I could hover over the SNote file and it'll give me an air view preview, but it lost some functionality as well as mentioned. So I hope they get it all figured out. And if you just click into this, you could see it opens up SNote editor and you can make edits to here. And it updates on here. And just in case you're wondering, does this sync backwards? Well, it kinda does and it kinda doesn't. So let's open up Evernote. And as you could see, here are some of the notes that I created from the Galaxy Note 3. But when you go in here, it won't let you edit this in the SNote editor because it's just a JPG file that it converted. Another thing I wanted to mention was that when I opened up Evernote first time on the Galaxy Note 3, it told me that I can get a free year subscription for Evernote Premium, which I believe it is making it possible for me to view Galaxy Note 3 SNote files on the Galaxy Note 2, because if you look at these, they are converted into images here, and I believe it is converting them on the cloud on the Evernote servers. Whether that is important to you or not, I'm not sure, but just keep in mind that you're going to need to pay a subscription after a year runs out if you are looking for this kind of functionality. So anyway, that's Evernote for the Galaxy Note 3. It has improved dramatically. Unfortunately, that update kind of goes back a step, but hopefully an update will arrive soon that addresses all these issues and adds some of those functionalities on that new update. This is Michael from the Daily Note 203 YouTube channel. For more videos on the Galaxy Note 2 and 3, please check out my YouTube channel and subscribe for more upcoming videos. Once again, thank you for watching.